What's this? The Flick Shack has closed down and will not reopen. Any unreturned tapes can be dropped off before September 22nd. It has been a privilege to serve as Providence Oaks' premier home cinema provider. Thank you for your patronage. All the best. Your Flick Shack proprietor, Angie. Interesting. I guess nobody's home.
It's heavier than I thought. Hi, Maureen.
P.O. people, I need to pause the music for a special message.
Hush, darling. I want to hear this. And so do you.
It's from our own Robert Harris, who wants to keep Providence Oaks pretty. Don't flatter yourself. He's talking about the trees. Take it away, Robert.
Dear people of Providence Oaks, I'm Robert Harris, and I oppose the plans for new apartments on Lakeview Drive. If you feel the same, let Town Hall know about it and give them a call. Let's keep Providence Oaks pretty.
Isn't that something? It could have been more juicy, I guess. But it does say exactly what he wants it to, which is rare for our Robert. Even though he does have his redeeming qualities, doesn't he just? I wonder how he came up with the idea, though.
Actually, I helped out a bit when he was recording it at Jack's studio.
Is that right?
Now, Maureen, don't Maureen this out of proportion.
I see. Robert wasn't kidding when he said he wants to keep pretty things around in Providence Oaks now, was he?
You think so?
Well, that's what I heard. Anyway, I actually wanted to talk to you about something else. What are you doing this Sunday evening, hon?
Something tells me I'm about to find out.
You know it. Listen here. I'm hosting a very special first-time open mic night this upcoming Sunday. We'll have some drinks, some food, discover the town's hidden talent, or not, if you know what I mean. It'll be a hoot.
More like a hoot and a half. Count me in.
Good. I already had you down on my list, of course, but it's nice of you to RSVP. That's settled then. I will see you this Sunday at 8 p.m. And tell everyone you meet, okay? Let me see you put those postal delivery muscles to good use.
Why do I have the feeling I don't have a choice here?
There you go. You're catching up. Now I have to go unpack some deliveries out back, but I will see you soon, darling. And don't forget about the open mic.
I couldn't if I wanted to.
Mail carrier Meredith.
Farmer Jack.
Good to see at least someone's working today.
As opposed to Frank?
As opposed to me. Can't harvest taters with all this rain. But Frank's not twiddling his thumbs, I can tell you that.
You spoke to him?
Yeah, just talked to him on the phone. He's mad as a wet hen. It's quite entertaining, actually. Thanks for dropping by, mail carrier Meredith. I gotta get back to it.
Isn't it well past harvesting season?
True enough, but something else is keeping me occupied.
Oh, okay. Good luck with that.
Thank you much.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. It's me.
Thank you for calling Alcoholics Anonymous. How may I help you?
Oh, please, Meredith. It's not that bad. You're just jealous.
Actually, I am.
I hope you mean about the weather.
Well, it did rain a lot here today.
Oh, just wait until the wet season really starts. And never ends.
Why haven't you told her yet? Let me talk to her.
Well, excuse me, Mrs. Weiss. Meredith, sorry to break it up. Your mom wants to talk to you.
Meredith, I'm so excited. Your dad and I found this cottage this weekend near the beach. It's so pretty. Not too big, but who wants to be inside anyway?
Wow, that sounds great. What's the plan? Live there?
Yes. We talk to the owner. We can rent it for the time being, spend the winter here. And if we like it, we can buy it and settle down here for good.
Wow, that's quite a big step. Life-changing and all that.
Isn't it something? And it means that our house will be vacant for a while. We won't put it on the market until we've tried out Florida for a few months. So, if you want to extend your stay in Providence Oaks...
Are you serious?
I'm pretty serious, yes. But it's a pretty big deal, so just think about it for now. Hmm?
Can I talk to her for a sec again?
Yeah, here comes your dad again. Bye, dear. I'm going to get us something bubbly.
Hey, Meredith. Just wanted to say that I'll call again at the end of this week. Have a great one.
Okay. Bye, Dad.
Memories, memories, memories. Of you and me. Memories.
Oh, Mickey, that was so deep. Right, Meredith?
Oh, yeah. Awesome.
It's in the darkness when my soul stars align and illuminate the real me.
Oh, baby, I'm so happy for you.
We need to celebrate this moment. I'll be right back, ladies.
Mickey can be difficult sometimes, but nights like these, I wouldn't want to be anywhere else but with him.
And that's why you're following him all the way to Canada?
It's also that he needs me. He would get into trouble without me.
Is she interrogating you again, June?
Oh, Mickey. Be nice to sweet Meredith.
I'm just kidding now. Sorry for being a hard ass the other day, Meredith. It's just that we need to be a bit cautious.
Cautious? Of what?
The man, of course. Always the fucking man.
The man? What man?
The man, you know, in general. Anything with authority, in whatever shape or form it appears.
I think I know what you mean. Feeling like a prisoner of society.
Hey, guys. Let's not spoil this evening with heavy stuff, okay?
Ah, you're so right, Junebug. Who cares about the man when I've got you? There's something that'll make you feel lighter. Much lighter. Meredith!
Sure.
My turn. How about some booze?
Sure. What do you have?
Beer, wine, and whiskey.
Whiskey. Why not?
Gotcha. Be right back.
Memories of you and me.
Memories.
All righty, here you go.
So, are you guys on the run?
What can I say? We've got a few unpaid parking tickets. Mickey had an argument with some cop, and then there's a bit of college and tax debt. Nothing major. So we're not really on the run. It's more like speed walking.
How are you guys gonna cross the border?
It's so exciting. Damien will pick us up with his Jeep tomorrow morning. We'll have a cozy hour under the blankets when we cross the border, and then we're good. Hey, I just realized we're abandoning the RV. You should totally have it. Mickey, can Meredith have the RV?
That piece of junk? Knock yourself out.
Really, guys? That's awesome.
No problem. We don't really believe in possessions anyway.
Whatever you decide, we'll leave it at the gas station. That's where we rendezvous with Damien.
Wild.
Memories, memories, memories of you and me. Memories.
Top of the Thursday morning, P.O. We don't have any callers today, so I'll bring up one of my own pet peeves.
P.O. positive or pet peeve?
The idiotic plans for pedestrianization of Main Street. It's... Well, don't get me started or I won't even have time for the weather. Speaking of, a few clouds early on, but they will be gone soon. Music time.
Walking in your garden.
These look like bills. No answer. Interesting.
Thank you.
Oh, dear. You're a sight for sore eyes.
Oh, hi, Miss J... Mildred? How so? Are you really that happy to see me?
It's just... this week, it's all a bit much for me. I need to get my hair done for Sunday's special evening, but I can't leave my cats alone. And then all of a sudden, Frank has gone missing. He still needs to bring me an envelope. Please tell me that you have it with you.
I'm afraid this is just a postcard. Mildred, are you gambling?
Oh, don't be a nosy posy, Meredith. Oh dear, he can't just have vanished into thin air, can he?
I wish I could tell you where he is.
Oh, Frankie boy, always making me worry too much. And I need to cancel the hairdresser's appointment, but what if I can't reschedule?
Perhaps I could look after your cats.
Would you, my dear? It's tomorrow evening. That would be such a relief for me. And the cats.
Tomorrow night? I'm really sorry, Mildred, but I already made plans for tomorrow.
Oh dear. I need to go inside and calm down a bit.
Meredith, look at this house on wheels. I have no idea where it came from, but it's absolutely rad.
It's mine, actually. Mickey and June gave it to me. You know, that young couple down by the lake campground.
Whoa, really? That's so tight. Here, they left this note on the driver's seat.
Oh, let me read it. Life's a journey and not a destination. Just grab the wheel and enjoy the ride. Love, M&J.
So, what are you going to do with it? You have to hit the road.
I actually don't really want it after all. Maybe you'd like to have it. You know, keep it here and tinker on it?
Oh, yes! That'd be amazing. You know I love tinkering. But it's going to need a lot of work.
Good to hear, Lori. I can already hear the cogs in your head spinning at top speed. What are your plans?
Well, if it's going to be here a while, I should give it a name first. Can't have such a beautiful vehicle and not give it a name. How about the Sea Turtle? Big, slow, washed up, just like a turtle. Or the Raccoon, because it's got brown spots and is full of trash. Or the Hermit Shell. It had many owners over the years, just like the shell of a hermit crab.
I like the Sea Turtle.
Good choice. I'll get working on it right away. See you later.
Bye.
Heavier than I thought.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. He could only look on in sheer terror as Madeline threw the key straight into the lake. Oh, yes. This is good stuff.
Important delivery.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, go away. If I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times.
You haven't told me anything. I'm new here.
Oh, bloody heck. Do I sound like I care? You lot are all the same to me. Just go away. How many yokels are there in this backwater town? Do they realize people come out to these kinds of places because they're supposed to be remote and quiet?
Sir, if you don't want to be disturbed, don't mail order anything.
I do beg your pardon. Yes, I am expecting a package. I didn't know you were from the Postal Service, ma'am.
Should it even matter who I am? Shouting at random strangers is generally considered rude.
All right, I'm sorry. It's just, I've been under a lot of pressure lately from my publisher, as well as my wife. I do appreciate your driving all the way up here, and Lord knows I'll be needing those ribbons. Just please leave them on the porch, and thank you.
Now, was that so hard?
All right. Now, where was I? She threw the key in the lake. Then what happens? Oh, Christ's sake, she made me lose my bloody train of thought. No, wait, I got it. And then he says...
Bye. Good afternoon, Miss Weiss.
Yikes, you creep! You keep giving me jump scares.
What?
What?
Don't try to be a wise guy. Or wise gal, Miss Weiss.
I can't help being a wise gal.
Very funny. That's also what your dad used to say. I'll continue. I wanted to let you know that today was my last day here.
Oh, really? Will Frank be coming back then?
That's all I have to say. Good luck.
Hello?
Hi, Em. It's me, Kay.
Oh, hi, Kay.
Good. You're home. Listen, I don't know if you're busy tonight, and I wouldn't normally bother you like this, but I'm kind of in a huge pickle at the moment, and now I'm imagining being inside of a huge pickle. Thanks, brain.
You sound a bit agitated.
Okay, so this is going to sound like I'm 16, but I have these tickets to a really big concert tonight for Barry and me, and it seems the babysitter has just bailed on me. All right, so maybe the babysitter part doesn't sound like I'm 16, I hope. Anyway, it's Journey, so I'm like, I need to go tonight, and I got these tickets ages ago. And it's a long drive to Portland, so we'll probably be out all night, and I promise you I've called everyone and their brother. Besides, they're really good kids to watch tonight.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Kay! Inside voice, Kay. Inside voice.
Yeah, sorry. You're totally right. I'm blabbering on R&I. Okay, don't freak out. You got this. All right, recap. Journey tonight, in Portland, got tickets, sitter bailed. So I guess you figured out by now that I'm awkwardly trying to ask if maybe you could do me a huge favor and watch Grace and Max tonight?
Hey, it's fine. Don't worry. I'll babysit tonight.
Oh my god, you serious? That would help me out in such a big way! And I would owe you big time. Huge!
You would, wouldn't you? Interesting.
Oh dear, never mind. Don't care. Can you be here around 6 p.m., so in like 30 minutes? You don't have to bring anything. There's food, videos, even a cardboard replica of Apollo 11 with a set of matching helmets. You're covered. See you in a bit!
All right! See ya! All right! Who wants s'mores?
Hey, guess who's back?
Frank? I'm so glad to see you again.
I'm so happy to be here again. I guess Morgan didn't stick around to welcome me back.
Good riddance.
Hell yeah, that clueless piece of work.
Tell me more. How'd you get rid of him?
Well, what can I say? Don't mess with the big boys. I guess they didn't understand that some of my customers do a little more than talking about their cats.
Are they criminals?
No, nothing that bad. Frank Coleman's no stranger to the high-stakes game. I've got lawyers in my inner circle. All it took were a couple of lawsuit threats.
Sweet. That should keep them off our backs for a while.
Haha, yes. But that buffoon will be back. You can bet on it.
What odds can you give me?
Haha, Meredith. I better get back to work.
A very good morning, Providence Oaks.
Theo, positive report. That key.
I wonder what it'll be today. Actually, no. Nancy, the floor is yours.
Yeah, Jack, I've got a pet peeve. Why do people start fake coughing when I'm smoking in my store? If you don't like it, just leave.
Thank you much, Nancy. And, well, if you're asking, it's not like people have other places to go besides the smokehouse that you call a general store. On to the weather forecast.
sunny in the first half of the day and some clouds in the second. Back to the playlist.
Robert?
How are you? I was away for a few days on an urgent job out of state.
I'm good. It's nice to see you again. Here's the mail.
Thanks, and likewise. Priority mail from Town Hall. Let's see what they have to say this time. Dear Mr. Harris, on behalf of yada yada yada, concerning Environmental Management Act 1213, yada yada yada. Wait. What? Listen to this. We have decided to postpone the construction of apartments for at least 6 months. We hope this satisfies you, as well as the many residents of Providence Oaks that contacted us with their unfiltered and enthusiastic comments. It worked. The plan worked.
Wow, great. So happy for you, Robert.
We need to celebrate this. How about tomorrow night? steak dinner at Moe's, or something else, on me.
Ah, oh, I'd love that.
Great. It's gonna be fun. See you tomorrow night, then. Gotta go now. The telephone troops need to know the assault can be abandoned.
Here's your mail.
Not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell every goodbye. Oh, it's not what we see, it's what we choose to be. Fire breath in open sky. It's not what we know.
That's lighter than I thought.
The waxworms have arrived.
Ew! Have I been walking around with worms?
You sure have. They're just in time. I'm taking a boat to the island this afternoon.
Oh, nice. A boat trip.
Hey, you can tag along if you want, like your father used to. But I'm not helping you with any wax worms.
I appreciate the invitation, but fishing's not for me.
Suit yourself, landlubber. Yeah, just make sure you have both oars in the water. That's what I always say.
Interesting. It's lighter than I thought.
Can
driving along the highway, above the dead.
Hello? Friday delivery day.
Well, just call me Friday Delivery K. Okay, no, that sounded better in my head.
Someone's in a good mood today.
Yes, thanks for looking after Max and Gracie last night. He were a real trooper for stepping in last minute.
No problem, they were great.
I appreciate the lie.
So, how was the concert?
Oh, yeah. Man, Journey is so good. Those songs have been stuck in my head all day.
Yeah, but Journey?
I know, right? There's just so much cool stuff being created right now, you know? I mean, Journey was cool. I got to know them through Barry at first, but I tell you, if Prince or New Order ever came to Portland, I would sell my spleen for tickets.
One spleen, two bands. That's quite the potential dilemma.
Oh, and I haven't even mentioned Cyndi Lauper, or Run DMC, or Stevie Wonder. And before you go there, I know you're probably setting up a joke about spleens and Hammond organs right now.
Joke's on you, because I don't even know what that means.
You know, music organ, body organ. Never mind. All jokes aside, though, I spent half the concert thinking about how I haven't really focused on my own music for a while now. Kids, work, all that stuff. So much going on. And I mean, I love tinkering, but right now, I'm not sure I'm even creating anything cool or just, you know? Not even Barry is allowed to listen to my songs at this stage, to be honest.
I'd love to hear your music sometime. I'm sure it's great.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Maybe I'll hold you to that. I was thinking, I have a mixtape with some of my stuff, you know? Just something I've been trying out with my new synthesizer.
I'd be honored.
That's great. It's just something I've been playing around with. Don't expect any fireworks. And hey, don't tell me what you think yet, yeah? You'll be my secret special audience of one, so I can get used to the idea of an audience.
Would this have anything to do with Sunday evening?
Okay. Don't tell anyone, but I'm thinking of performing a song on my new synth this Sunday. Holy crap, I just said that out loud. Dude, you are coming to the open mic, right?
Of course, that's great. Wild horses couldn't drag me away.
But act cool, yeah? No one else knows yet. See you there.
Sure thing. Back to my own journey for now. Haha.
Nope, ignoring that. Bye now.
Kay's tape. Let's have a listen.
Okay. Okay. Driving along the highway, headlights light up the sign. Thinking of what might have been, radio keeps track of time.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. Guess what I signed today?
The contracts for the Adit 87 deal?
Oh, yes. You are now talking to Steve Mitchell, CEO of a multi-million dollar enterprise.
But before I continue my insufferable bragging, I have a thing or two to say to you, about you. You've been a huge part of the success of this company, and I feel this is just the beginning. We're entering the golden age of personal computers, and we've got front row tickets. The past 2 weeks have made me realize that I couldn't have done it without you, and I'm going to need you even more in the coming years. So, here's a new monster deal I want you to think about. Become a partner in the company for 20% of the shares and a significant pay raise. Significant. The only condition is that I need your commitment for the next 5 years. So, there it is. Think about it, and let's talk about it more when you're back in the office.
Oh, wow, Steve. That sounds great.
Just let it sink in a bit. I don't need an answer right now. I have to get back to my million-dollar lifestyle. Actually, no, I need to get cranking on lots of stuff. Talk soon, Meredith.
Previously on Bon Appetit.
That burger joint across the street is killing our business.
I don't get it, monsieur. Our food is so much more sophisticated and delicious than these disgusting hamburgers. Don't you agree, Jean-Paul? Oh, yes. These hamburgers are fantastic.
A postcard from Angie.
Miss Meredith, I am so, so sorry I haven't been able to see you. It's just that I've been swamped organizing my not-so-timely exit from Providence Oaks. I'm sure you understand. You've probably seen the foreclosure notice. That certainly helped expedite my decision to leave. Anyway, I'll be honest. I'm still thinking about that kiss we shared in the car. And I don't usually dwell on these kind of things. So, feel special, Meredith. I hear you're going to the open mic night on Sunday. I wasn't planning on going, but I want to see you before I leave. I'm really anxious to find out what you've decided to do. Whether you're going to stay in this town, or go back to the city, or do something else entirely. And I'm going to be forward, as you know I always am. I'd like to know if little old me figures into those plans, somehow. So, anyway, I'll see you there, yeah? Love, Angie.